Hi, I'm George, and in this Minecraft Custom Resource Pack video, I'll be showing you how to change the texture on armor. Now, if you like this video, make sure you hit that like button. Don't forget to click on share and subscribe, and check out my channel for a bunch more videos. All right, now the first thing we need to do is to get the files that we need to work on the texture for this. Let's switch over to a file window, and I'll show you where to find those files. There we go. Now, I won't be going through the whole process of making a custom resource pack. I've shown that in a previous video. I'll put a link for that in the description. But here's the basics. There is the beginning jar file right there. I unzip this file right over here. And then from here, I copied out the assets folder right there. Let's take a look over here real fast, where you can find the original pack MC Meta and pack PNG. These are my customized versions in here. You find the originals inside of the jar file unzipped. Let's go inside here. Now this is all alphabetical, so if you just scroll way down, down to the P's, because of course this is looking at pack.mcmeta. Here we go. There is the default pack.mcmeta, and there is the default pack.png file. So that's where you'll find those two. They're just inside of that folder. Okay, we have our assets folder. Let's go inside here. I've cleaned everything else out that I don't need. So we have just the Minecraft folder, just textures. I cleaned everything out of there as well. And in here, all we need is the item folder and the models folder. Everything else can go. Inside of the item folder, again, I cleaned everything out that I don't need, but left in these. Now these are what show inside of the inventory. So we need to have those for the inventory. And then inside of models and armor, that's where you'll find your armor. I left in just the diamond armor. We'll use that for this video. Now, I'll be doing this in Adobe's Photoshop Elements program. It's my personal favorite for editing this kind of graphics, but you can use any graphics program, it doesn't matter. It needs to be able to handle PNG files. It needs to be able to work with transparency, and it's helpful if it can work with layers, but that's just about all you actually need. So just about any graphics program will work out just fine. The free paint.net works out great. The Windows 3D Paint works just fine as well. Okay, I'll bring this up inside of Photoshop Elements. Okay, here we are inside of Photoshop Elements, and I have this camo file right here. We'll be using that for our texture. Let's just get that out of the way. These are the two files that make up the diamond armor. There's your helmet right here. There is the breast piece. Over here we have the legs and the boots, but all the stuff together makes the armor. Now these are real small size. We're going to be upraising this in just a minute. But first let me get these out of the way, and then back here, these are the files that show up inside of the inventory. Okay, let's get these out of the way. We'll get back to those as our second pass here. So on the first pass, we have this file. Now I'll be showing you the steps on this one. You'll need to repeat the steps on this file and also on this file as well. Same exact process though. Okay, we need to make this a higher resolution so we can get that nice detail in that camouflage armor. So I'll put this up four times. So let's go up here to Image, come down to Resize and Image Size. All programs have something like this. Now the width in here is 64. I'm just going to make this 256. The resolution should stay at 72. And then down here, you should have an option for setting how the resize is handled. And what you want is something which will preserve hard edges. A lot of programs call that nearest neighbor, but look for preserve hard edges or nearest neighbor. That just keeps things sharp. If you use something else, then this will go blurry when you make it larger. Okay, choose OK. There we go, and let's fit this back on screen again. All right, that's the first part. Second part, let's bring that camo picture in here. And I have that one right there. Now inside of Photoshop Elements and a lot of other programs as well, you can just drag this from the one file into the other file like that. Some programs may have to go over here, copy, and then go over here and paste. You know, whatever, just get the camo into this. Now this is too big, as you can see, so I'm just going to grab the corner up here and I'll pull this down until I can shrink this down to fit. And I want it just big enough to go clear to the top and bottom. Okay, there's the top. And let's pull it down to fit the bottom. There we go, and choose OK. I'll now make a copy of this. Now it's a little bit soft, as you can see in there, because I did that resize. I'm just going to sharpen this up first. Again, any technique you want for sharpening, bring it up just a little bit, maybe 50% I think on this one should work out okay. There's before and there's after. That's good. Okay, nice and sharp. I'll now make a duplicate of this layer. This is where having layers comes in handy. Duplicate layer, and then I'll pull that one over to the side. Now this is set up to tile. So if I just click it on here and go over one more like that, it just exactly doubles that. And notice how we don't have any armor showing over here, so I can ignore that part of this. I'm now going to merge these two camo layers together. Right click and merge layers. So it's now camo on one layer and then the armor on another layer. Now what you need to do here is you need to have this transparency on that camo layer. There are two different ways of doing that. One is to use a tool like the magic wand. I'll click over in this area and then down here where it says add, click into this section. So now I have all the transparent areas selected. I could then go up here to this layer and then just delete that, hit the delete key and just cut that out. I prefer doing it a little bit differently. It gives me some more flexibility for the future. And that is, I have my selection now with that magic wand. I'll invert that selection, select inverse, and then I can go up here and using this button, the add layer mask, I can add that as a layer mask onto this layer. So I'm now just hiding that part of the camo that we don't need. And what that does is it keeps that whole thing in there because I want to use that on a different picture. Okay, so here we go. We now have our camo in the shape of the armor. You could just do it like this, but I want to go just a little bit further on this. I want to blend this into that diamond armor. And for that, I'll use a blend mode. In this case, I want to use linear light. Just kind of blends the two together and gives it kind of nice, bright Minecraft style colors. You can see some of the outlines in here for the armor. It helps it look a bit better. And I'll bring the opacity down on that just a bit, down to 75%. And there we go. So there's our basic armor setup. And that's all you have to do for changing your texture. If you want to, you could come in here and just paint anything you want in here. It's up to you however you want to do that, but it's the same basic process. Okay, now I need to save this out. So do File. I'll first do a save, and this will be saving it as a Photoshop file. What that does is it saves the layers for me. So if I want to, I can go back in the future and then easily, you know, redo this or make adjustments, whatever. So I'll save it as a Photoshop file first, just for future editing. And now we need to have this saved as a PNG file. So File, Save As. And I'll change this down to PNG, choose save. It'll put it on top of the original one right there. Choose yes, and there we go. That's now done. Now you need to do the exact same thing on that other file right here. Just follow those exact same steps for this file, and then both of those will be done. Okay, let's now take a look at one of these other images here. These are the images that are in the inventory. Now I need to have that camo picture in here. Let's just get rid of this. There we go. So I'll open that back up again. Basically the same steps that I just did for the actual armor, but for these instead. Now this is a much smaller picture, so this would be much, much larger. Just pull that in like that. Now notice when I pull it in, it wouldn't go in. That's because this is an index file, which means that this is a PNG 8 and not a PNG 24. This is over here is a PNG 24 file. So you need to fix the mode in here for this. So go up to Image, come down to Mode, and change from Index Color to RGB Color. There we go. Now I can drag this over there, and it goes in just fine. Just get that out of the way. Now, as you can see here, it's much, much too large. I'll need to shrink that image down a lot. So I'm first going to zoom out of this, go way down like that, and now I can see the bounding box for that camo. And I can just pull that down, pull the corners in, and make that a lot smaller until I get some of that camouflage coloration in there. And that looks pretty good. And then let's go ahead and zoom back in again on that one, fit screen. There we go. So I just have some of that basic camo shape. It doesn't need to be exactly anything on this particular step. This is just for inside of that inventory. Okay, the same steps as before. Let's change the blend mode to linear light. We can see through that now. Let's change the opacity here to 75%. Now all I need to do is to get a layer mask up here. So I'll come down to this layer, let's hide that one. Grab the magic wand, click in the transparent area, reverse that selection, there it is. Go back up to this layer, hit the layer mask button, and there we go. There is the camo for the inventory. Now you need to do the exact same steps for the rest of your inventory down here, like your helmet, your leggings, and so forth. But it's a little bit easier now because we've already resized that camo layer. Again, I need to change the mode on this. Let's change that to RGB. There we go. Back over here, grab the camo layer, drag it on here. There it is, about like that. I'll delete this layer mask, right click and delete layer mask. And then just do that layer mask step again. Again, this magic wand, click in the transparency, select inverse. and back up to this layer and hit that layer mask button, and there we go. So that's all there is to it. Just repeat those steps for the other two parts of the inventory. And then, of course, we need to save this out again. Okay, I'll turn the camera off just for a couple of minutes, and I'll finish up those other files. And we'll then go back over and take a look at this inside of the folders again and put that together for a resource pack. Okay, here we are back inside of Textures. Let's look at the items first. There we go. There are the Photoshop files. And you can see right here, there are those nice green camo versions of the items. Let's check the models and armor. There are those Photoshop files, and there's a nice camo version of the armor. So that's all set. Let's now go back here again. Now all we need to do is to zip this up. Now I've used a custom PNG file in here for my pack.png. I doubled the size. This is now 256 by 256 instead of 128 by 128, just for more detail. It can be any picture you want in there as long as it's square and a PNG. That's all that matters. Inside the pack.mc meta, I simply changed the description to say camo armor right there. Notice that the format is still 5. Now, if you're used to making these resource packs, you'll notice that the basic layout here is a bit different. This is the 1.16 layout. All they did was just reverse the position of the pack format and the description. They just swapped those two. Everything else is the same. Either one will work. You can use the 1.15 pack.meta just as well. Just make sure you have the description correct in there and close that down. All right, let's go ahead and zip this up. So it's the assets and the pack.mc meta and the pack.png. Right click, and I use 7-zip. We'll add this to archive. And I'll just change that name up there so it says camo armor. There it is, and choose OK. Let's now open up another drive window. It doesn't matter where it is. There's my This PC window. That's just fine. Now up here in the address bar, just type in percent, app data percent. That takes you into the roaming folder right here, and you want to go into the .minecraft folder. There it is. And in here, go into resource packs right there. Now for this, I'm just going to copy this over. I'll use the right mouse click and just drag that over like that and copy. There it is. So that's now inside the resource packs folder. Okay, I'm now going to open back up Minecraft and let's switch that over and see how that resource pack worked. Okay, there I am with the regular diamond armor on. That's the standard default look. Let's hit the escape key and come down to options and resource packs. And you should see that new resource pack over here on the left-hand side. Click on the arrow. That'll bring it over to the right-hand side. Choose Done. It's going to reload Minecraft with that new resource pack in it. Click Done again. Back to game. And there we go. There is our nice camo armor that we just made. Let's now double-check, make sure we're seeing this in the inventory as well. I hit the E key. And here's the inventory. There you go. You can see it right there, showing camo in that part of the inventory. Let's also check down here, and there it is inside of that inventory as well. So that's why we did those other little small files, so it shows up correctly in here. This will also show up correctly now if you put the armor into an item frame as well. So there we go. That's how you can customize your armor, change the texture on your armor inside of Minecraft Java. Now, if you like this video, make sure you hit that like button. Don't forget to click on share, subscribe, hit that bell icon for notifications of my new videos, and of course, check out my channel for a bunch more Minecraft stuff. All right, and I'll see you next time.